My folks has been around for a couple of years in Montreal. It has now a studio in Toronto and a studio in Pagoda. And we recently joined VFX, which is in various locations across North America.
So in Houdini 17.5, VFX released this new technology called the Procedural Dependency Graph, or PDG, that allows artists to be able to distribute tasks in a procedural way out to a farm or even nodes on a workstation. You guys were one of the early adopters of PDG.
Yeah, so we used the PDG right from the release of 17.5, and it took a couple of weeks before using it into a project, but we soon saw the real value of that piece of technology for production. And one of the main projects where we used PDG was Siren Season 3.
So let's talk a little bit more about Siren. What's the premise of the show?
Yeah, so Siren is a episodic show where we worked on season 2 and 3. It's a world where mermen and mermaids exist, and in the final season, there are some rivalries between two tribes, and it ends up with an epic underwater battle in episode 10.
So what were some of the ways that Houdini was used on Siren?
So we use Houdini from the beginning of the pipeline. After tracking the cameras, we do the layout work in Houdini. And we also do the set dressing, so a lot of environment work as well, scattering of rocks, algae, and other underwater vegetation. And once our main battleground was formed for this epic sequence, we then lend the work to other departments. We of course did some animation, but the next department that was using Houdini was the FX department, where we did most of our usual FX work, some bubbles, some effects, some smoke. But the FX department had a new challenge, which was crowd simulation.
The fact that there wasn't any ground, the fact that they were all swimming, usually with crowds, you have your walk cycles, you have your ground and your up victor, but this went all out the window. Other big challenge was that the fact that it was a fight, so one crowd of the enemy and one crowd of the good guys had to connect, and all the collisions were needed to be perfect when the weapon struck the other weapon. It needed to hit at the right place at the right time, but they also needed to start from very far apart and clash together. We needed everything to be pinpoint perfect, but it was also a crowd which needed to be beautiful all around in the shot, and we also needed to understand what was going on in the big underwater battle.
So what Houdini tools did you use in this process?
To do the crowds, we used all of the crowd tools from Houdini. We started off with agents, we imported animations and cut them into clips to then play with them in DOPS using states and a lot of effects stuff to blend all these states together. We also used PDG from another artist that helped us export and send to all the other departments once all the crowd was done and ready to go. The main advantage that Houdini gave us was, like always, it's not a question of if Houdini could do it, it was a question of how we could do it. And the fact that we had this big problem that we never did before, Houdini gave us the security that we could do it.
So what would you say to a Houdini artist who hasn't tried PDG yet?
I would say get to it. It's worth your while. I think it's another mindset that you have to put yourself into. But as a Houdini artist, you already have some of the skills required to really leverage Houdini for your workflows. And I think every one of us has this workflow where you do repetitive work and you can automate it. But don't see PDG just as a workflow enhancement or a pipeline tool. You can also use it as a creative tool just to let you iterate faster, put out more variations. It's a tool that can be leveraged in many different ways.